Phil, how did you find out, when and how did you find out that you had won a Nobel Prize?
So I was in Boston visiting relatives, which was probably less fun for the Nobel people, but it was good for me because I think what they like to do is that they have this at 11:45, I think it is, Sweden time. And as a result, in St. Louis, if I get the time change right, it's like 4:45. And so they like to have like a reporter show up on your doorstep very early in the morning and wake you up, and you come down in your slippers and bathrobe and with your glasses crooked and groggy and your hair messed. And then they say you've just won the Nobel Prize. And that's what they want to have. They like to have that moment. But in Boston, I was in the hotel, and my phone had do not disturb on. And they didn't know I was there. And when the alarm went off at 7:30 a.m., I woke up and saw that I had a gazillion messages. And somebody had said a couple days before that this is the day. So I'm going, did I get a Nobel Prize? And I said, and my initial thought was it's more likely I got some prank calls. So I went directly to the Nobel Prize website, figuring that wouldn't be a prank call, and there was my name. It's like, okay.
Are pranks like that big in the academic community?
I've heard a couple of cases. Usually it's something where they think the person is kind of full of themselves and
Okay.
obsessed with the idea of getting a Nobel Prize, and they think that they deserve it and blah blah blah. And
Okay.
then they call them up and pretend it is, I don't know. It seems
Okay.
kind of mean, but it's I'm for childish behavior, but it doesn't really hurt anybody.